Welcome in. It's time to be liberated from the chaos of working in your business. Scott Beebe, the Business on Purpose podcast. Thanks for joining me. Hey, at the time of this recording, we're getting to the end of the year, and this is prime time to start thinking about forecasting for the following year. So whenever you're listening to this, if it's the beginning of the year, mid-year, the bottom line is you got to take some time to be able to make a plan for your forecasting. And so I thought I would just walk through a little simple template that you can do some simple forecasting. You don't have to be a CFO or a controller to be able to do this. It's pretty simple. Now, there are a couple of tools you've got to have in play in order to get this done. And the reason I'm talking about this on this episode is because we just walked through this with one of our heroic small business owners yesterday. And so I thought, wow, this is a good little talking point to be able to talk on the podcast here. So here we go. Again, you don't have to be a certified financial analyst, an advisor, a CPA. Those guys are great to have around, by the way. You need a couple of those. But if you want to do it, just a simple forecast for the following year, there's a couple things you need to have in mind. Number one, you need to go back and get some historical numbers. Now, some of you may be going, I don't really have those. Okay. The old Chinese proverb, right? Best time to plant a tree 10 years ago, second best time right now. If you don't have financial software, QuickBooks, Wave Accounting, whatever it might be, Xero spelled with an X, by the way, you need to get something. Wave Accounting, by the way, is what we use. It is actually free. It's ad supported, and we've used it since the foundation of our business, and it works great for what we need it for. But bottom line, if you don't have financial software, you need to get financial software. And if you are working with a bookkeeper, clearly they've got the financial software. Hopefully they've got the financial software. I have seen some bizarre cases. But anyway, the first thing that you've got to do is look historically. And so I like to look back at the last couple of years. Some businesses, some industries are going to be very fluid. You might do $600,000 in revenue this year, you might do $1.8 next year, and then $900,000 the following year. In a larger business, you might do $8 million this year, $12 million next year, $18 million the following year, and then $6 million the next year. I'll say it again, and I'll continue to say it. I'm not as interested in total revenue as I am in what your real profit is, and we'll get that in just a minute. So, first thing is let's get some historical numbers of what your total revenue is. Also want to get some historical numbers of what your total expenses are. I also want to get and just write out, you can do all this on a little simple spreadsheet. Just open it up, put, you know, the years across the top. So if you go back and let's say it's 2014, 15, 16, 17, and you're projecting into 18, or whatever years you're doing, you can go back a couple of years or 1 year or 4 years just to get some historical data. Put those numbers there. Make a line for total revenue. Put all your total revenue numbers there. Make a line for total expenses. Put all your total expense numbers there. A line for cost of goods sold. Now, for some of you, you might be asking, where do I find all this information? If you run a profit and loss statement, some call it a net income statement, you'll be able to find most of it, hopefully all of it, there. And so I like to have a total revenue number, a total expense number, a cost of goods sold number. You should see that on your profit and loss, commonly known as a P&L statement. And then I also like to pull out taxes and payroll. Now, taxes and payroll are going to be typically a part of your total expense number, but I still like to pull those out just to see what they are as a percentage of total revenue. Why? Is because it helps us do budget thinking forward. And so I've got a listing out of my total revenue, total expenses, cost of goods sold, total payroll, total taxes, and then you're going to have a net income number. And with that net income number, if you're following the 5 bank account profit model, you're going to have a real profit number. I hope you're following that. If not, I talk about it somewhere around here. If you've not read the book Profit First, you need to read that book. Okay, once you've got all that, then what I like to do is I like to pit every number against the total revenue number. What is our percentage of expense to total revenue? What's our percentage of cost of goods to total revenue? What's our percentage of payroll to total revenue, etc.? And you go all the way down. And then you can begin to look to next year. Now, I got to admit, it's kind of a best guess to think about. Some of you can forecast and project based on contracts that you've got coming up. Some of you have to do it based on what you've done historically. But regardless of how you do it, you got to start to settle in on a total revenue number for next year. Then you can take those percentages that you've pitted against themselves in the different categories, total expenses, payroll, et cetera, and with those percentages, based on what your anticipated total revenue is, whether it's higher, the same, or lower, it doesn't matter. You use those percentages. That'll give you your budget numbers next year for each of those categories, and then you can start going item by item. In your total expense category, you can say, okay, office supplies, marketing, whatever, and then you start to roll that out. But that's how you do a really, really simple forecast for next year. And again, if you're not doing the profit model, I highly, highly encourage you to do that. If you need more information, email me, scott@mybusinessonpurpose.com, and I'll give you some insight on that. So I hope that helps. Simple forecasting for next year and what you need to get ready financially to make sure you've got everything done. But if you don't have accounting software, that's your first step. Thanks for joining me on the Business on Purpose podcast. I'll see you next time, and go be liberated from the chaos of working in your business.